What do you do if you want to set up a two-factor authentication app like Google Authenticator, Microsoft Authenticator, or Authy, and you only have one device? In other words, how in the heck are you supposed to scan a QR code on your phone from your phone? That's a question I've been getting a lot, so I want to provide a very quick tutorial to walk you through the surprisingly easy solution. Welcome to All Things Secure. My name's Josh, and I'm going to use Twitter on my phone here as an example. So let's say that I'm trying to add 2FA security on my account. And as I go through the process, I'm given this QR code to scan. You've probably seen this before, right? Well, obviously, since I'm on my phone, I can't scan that QR code. So what do I do? Well, as you can see here below the QR code where it says can't scan QR code, in most cases, you'll either see a link like this or it'll even say manual code or there'll just be a code down there below the QR code. In this case, when I click that link, you can see that it gives me this 16 character code that I want to copy. That's the kind of code that you're looking for. Now, I'm going to open up my Authenticator app. And since I have a dummy account on Google Authenticator, I'm going to use that here. Click the plus button, and now instead of clicking scan a QR code, you're gonna click enter a setup key. Every Authenticator app is gonna have something like this. You can name the account whatever you want. Now, obviously, since this is a Twitter account, I wanna put Twitter somewhere in the account name, and then I'm going to paste that 16 character code here in the key. Now, most of the time, you'll just wanna keep it in the time-based unless you're specifically instructed otherwise. And when you click add, you're gonna see that it now appears in your Authenticator app. I'm gonna click copy, copy that code right here, and then I'm going to switch back over to Twitter where it requests this code to verify that I set everything up correctly. So if you did it right, the code will be accepted and your account is now secured using 2FA. Now, if you have a problem at this point, sometimes it's because this is a time-based code, and if it took you too long to get over to the next place, then you're gonna have to go back and get a new code again and switch back over to that. So just make sure that as the time expires, that you're giving yourself enough time to switch over to that new app, copy the code in, and then verify the 2FA codes. So at this point, in order to use 2FA, you'll have to open up your Authenticator app. You're gonna copy that code and then switch over to whatever app you're using and do so within enough time. I know it's a bit inconvenient, but that's just how it works. Now wait, before you click away, there are two important things that I want you to understand here about 2FA. First, please make sure that you keep a backup of the code that you just copied, or you can set up a second Authenticator application on a different device. The problem I've seen too many times is when people accidentally delete their Authenticator app, or they lose their phone, or it's stolen, and now they don't have a backup and they lose access to their account. So don't let that be you. My second piece of advice is to consider something known as a 2FA key instead of an Authenticator app. Now, I know this isn't a free option, but in my opinion, it's a much better security option and it's easier to use. So you can watch this video here about setting up a 2FA key to see how it works and see if that's something that's right for you. I hope this short tutorial was helpful. If so, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment with any questions.